Welcome to the training, Call Restricted Operations Using Tokens API. This video is designed for developers preparing to call a restricted operation for an application that's been registered and authorized for the Selling Partner API. In what follows, we'll explain restricted operations and provide instructions for getting a restricted data token, or RDT. We'll also review individual roles, operations, and restricted reports. If, before watching this module, you'd like more information about registering or authorizing an application for SP API or connecting and calling, refer to the relevant videos in our Integrate with SP API series. Let's start with an overview of Selling Partner API for Tokens, or Tokens API. Tokens API provides registered and authorized applications with a secure way to access a customer's personally identifiable information, or PII. Many calls that applications make to SP API don't access PII or other sensitive data. When an application requires access to PII to perform an operation, Amazon defines that operation as restricted and puts safeguards in place to ensure the customer data that's shared is required by the operation. This data might include information about a specific order or a customer's shipping address. Tokens API helps ensure this kind of data is provided to developers and selling partners safely and securely. When a developer calls Tokens API and specifies the type of restricted operation they want to call, they receive a short-lived RDT in return. They then include the RDT in a call to the restricted operation. The RDT authorizes the call and returns a response with the requested information, including any required PII. Before you can get an RDT and call a restricted operation, you'll need to have a registered and authorized SP API application. As a developer, you'll also need to ensure that both your profile and application include the SP API role necessary for accessing the restricted operation you want to call. There are three different restricted roles, each of which provides access to a separate group of selling operations and resources. The role Direct-to-Consumer Shipping provides access to operations and reports that selling partners use to ship orders directly to customers. The Tax Invoicing role provides access to operations that help generate tax invoices. And the Tax Remittance role provides access to related operations that calculate and remit sales tax. For more information about restricted roles and to learn how to add one or more to your developer profile and application, refer to our video Intro to SP API Roles. After the necessary roles have been added to your developer profile and your application is registered and authorized with those roles selected, you're ready to call a restricted operation. There are several restricted operations available grouped under various APIs. If the operation you want to call is on the following list, you'll need to call Tokens API and get an RDT to get a response. Note that the last operation under the Report API, Get Report Document, is only considered restricted when it's used to pull a report that contains PII or other sensitive customer data. Here's the full list of restricted report types. If you're calling Get Report Document for a report type not on this list, you won't need to use Tokens API and an RDT, but can call the operation as you normally would. Let's review the process for calling a restricted operation step by step. Start by calling the Create Restricted Data Token operation, passing the parameter Restricted Resources. Here's an example request for an RDT token that will authorize the operations Get Order Address, Get Order Buyer Info, and Get Shipment. A successful response will include the parameters Restricted Data Token and Expires In. Restricted Data Token is your short-lived RDT. Expires In is the number of seconds your RDT will last. This will be 3600 or 1 hour. Here's an example response. After you get a response, you can call your chosen restricted operation or operations. Include the RDT in the X-AMZ access token header. This is the same header where you usually include a login with Amazon or LWA access token for an unrestricted operation. Here's an example request. For more information about the X-AMZ access token header, refer to our video, Integrate with SPAPI, Step 3B, Connect to SPAPI Manually. It's worth noting that a path from a restricted operation can be either specific or generic. A specific path contains a selling partner's order ID, shipment ID, or a report document ID. A generic path doesn't contain this information. It's also worth noting that for the Get Report Document operation, the path must always be specific. Here are examples of both specific and generic paths. This concludes our training on Tokens API. If you'd like to learn more, visit the SPAPI documentation website and select Tokens API Use Case Guide from the table of contents. Thanks for watching.